everyone, this is Arlene. I'm here today to share some Christmas cards that I created using some of the holiday products from My Favorite Things. I had so much fun creating these cards and I was having my little MFT withdrawals. I placed a fairly good-sized order and I was so excited to play with them and I really just got at it and made some Christmas cards. I still have a ton more cards to make. Luckily I have time off next week before the actual Christmas holiday. And so I am going to pump out a whole bunch of cards for, some family and friends. So hopefully if I mail them, they'll get out on time. But anyways, let me go ahead and share some of the cards I made with you. There's four that you're looking at here and I used a couple of, stamp sets from My Favorite Things. The first one that I have here is one of my all-time favorite, MFT iconic, images, and this is of the Pure Innocence little girl, and I absolutely love coloring her. She's so fun, and I was having withdrawals from Copic coloring. I haven't picked up my Copic markers in, gosh, you guys, it's been so long, and so I had a whole bunch of fun coloring her up. I paper pieced her, and I used some papers by My Mind's Eye, and let me pull that out right here. It's called The Merry Days of Christmas. Really pretty paper stack, but you can see this is the plaid that I used on her dress. And then here's the design paper that I used on the front of the card. So anyways, I used some I Am Roses products here on the corner. You'll see some Christmas leaves and some poinsettias in white. And you'll see under here this new open scallop oval. Let me show you the die. It's really fun. I love it. This is what it looks like. And it's very intricate. And you can't see the holes. There's little holes around the die-namics, but it's covered up by the layering that I did to cut out the image. So, but super duper fun. And then also on the border here, I used the small open scallop border and it's peeping out along the side there. That's from My Favorite Things as well. And then I used the fishtail banner, which is part of the first award ribbon dynamic set. So that's the front of my card, and then the inside I kept it pretty simple. This right here, it's from the stamp set Be Merry, but I used this new die set from My Favorite Things, and it's called the Mix and Match banner set, and it looks like this. It comes with four different banners. Really super fun, and they're really good size. They're a lot bigger than the other banners that MFT has on their site, but I use this one right here with the ornate edge. So that's what I use to stamp the sentiment on the inside of my card. So that's my first card. And let me go ahead and go show you this one. This one I had so much fun with. So by the way, here is Holly, PI, Holly, she's called Holly Girl. There's the name of it right there, Holly Girl. Okay, and then this is the stamp set, stamp and dynamic set that I used for my next project. And this is the dynamic set right here, and it's an ornament set, which is really fun. It's a miniature ornament set, and you'll see how small when you look at my A2 size card. But this is the set, and has a lot of fun little sentiments, and I apologize for the glare, a lot of fun little sentiments, and lots of different elements that you can use to stamp your die cuts. And so this is what I ended up doing. I ended up using some vellum and I used the snowflakes that came in the set. I used this one, and this one right here. And I stamped all over a piece of vellum using this stays-on opaque cotton white, because you can pretty much stamp on anything with this. You can stamp on metals, on vellum, on plastic. So I stamped with that. And then I just basically adhered the vellum down with brads, but before I did that, I put some of these fun ornaments in there. And I cut the ornaments out using some glitter paper that I got from Michaels. And here's a bunch of them that I didn't end up using, but I used the dynamics to cut these out, ornaments dynamics, so you can see them. They're so cute. And they come with little different accents. You have the little ornament topper, so you put that on your ornament top, and then you have the different shaped ornaments. Here's this one. And then there's these little stars that you can use to accent your project. So really fun. And there's like this little tag too. There's a little tag and there's this little holly also right there, little holly. You guys can see that. So anyway, so what I did is I adhered those down onto my card first before I put the layer over so they can just barely peep through the vellum. I like how that came out. It's kind of neat. And it kind of tones down the glitter a little bit. And then over here, I used the mini penance dynamics and I stamped joy and good cheer. And those came from the little sentiments that come with the stamp set. And then when you open it up, it's just really simple. I just did some layering, and then I stamped Merry Christmas from the stamp set. And then here's another one of the ornaments. And I used the star instead of the ornament topper on the top of that ornament. So that's that card. And then these two cards here I had so much fun with because I am in love with My Favorite Things Inspired By collection. It's a really nice, to me, it's got a real vintage feel. But this is the set that I used. And this is the Inspired By Christmas. And I love the Saint Nick image on here. It's really, really vintage and fun. And I really love working with things like that. And the cool thing about the MFTs Inspired By set is when you do your Copic coloring with these, it makes it so much easier because the cast shadows are already included in the stamped images. So, but anyhow, that's what it looks like. And then, so here's my first card. What I did is I stamped Saint Nick, and I didn't do any Copic coloring on these. What I decided to do was bust out with my Distress ink in Walnut Stain, and I just went to town with the Distress. So here I have just some plain ivory cardstock, and I stamped him with my Memento in the, is it called Rich Cocoa? And then I actually put some stickles on his hat. So I don't know if you guys can see that, but his hat is got the shimmery white on there. And I used the frosted lace stickles to do that. Okay, and then Distress, Distress. And then I used some I Am Roses poinsettias here. And then Peace is a sentiment from the stamp set. And then I used the notch tag die-namics, looks like this. And I tucked it in behind the poinsettias. And then over here in vellum, and I love this new die-namics, you guys. It's so huge. You could fit so many different sentiments on it and do so many things with it. But you could see by the size of my hands, this is a clearly sentimental label die-namics. And it's nice and big. I like it. And I basically cut it out with vellum. And then I layered on top of that one of the pieces of the Sweet Stack die-namics. And then I stamped Tis the Season from the stamp set on there and then distressed it. And then the inside, I just have the sleigh, and then the sentiment here is from the stamp set, Believe in the Magic of Christmas. So that's that. And then on this card, oh, and one thing I wanted to point out here is I made my own designer paper. I didn't use designer paper. What I did is I took some craft cardstock, and I stamped multiple times over and over again, Joy to the World. And that's included in the stamp set right here, Joy to the World. Okay, so you can make your own background with the stamps. It's really fun. You don't need to use designer paper all the time. And I did the same thing with this one in terms of the background paper, craft cardstock, and then I stamped the Believe in the Magic of Christmas from the stamp set. And then I stamped the sleigh again with the Memento ink and Rich Cocoa, and then layered it on top of glitter paper. I added three little blings in here just to kind of add a little something to it. I used an I Am Roses poinsettia here, and I distressed it with my Walnut Stain Distress ink. Since everything was just kind of distressed, the flower stood out too much white, so I just edged it a little bit with the Walnut Stain. And then over here, I have the Framed Greetings die-namics, and I stamped the sentiment from the Inspired By Christmas set. It says, have yourself a merry little Christmas. And then the inside, I just layered some ivory cardstock onto some glitter paper and stamped a sentiment from the stamp set, and then the little ribbons with bells from the stamp set as well. So anyways, guys, those are my cards from My Favorite Things, and so much fun. I can't wait to share more cards with you guys. I'm just in this, like, holiday kick right now. I have ornaments and cards going like crazy in my house. I forgot, before I go, guys, I wanted to share some of the other products that I got from My Favorite Things that I haven't been able to use yet, and I'll be using when I finish making up my cards and stuff next week. But this one is P.I. Christmas Stocking Girl. Isn't she adorable? She's so cute. I can't wait to paper piece her. Those are her little PJs. And it says, may your Christmas be filled with love and happiness. It's just a little thank you from Kim. She inserted that with the order. And then I have the clearly sentimental about Pearls of Wisdom. So there's like different sentiments, and this is one of the free sets if you spend $60 or more. And I love the clearly sentimental sets. They have very touching and very nice sentiments to add to cards. So that's what that is. Sorry for the glare. So there's wake up every morning with the thought of something wonderful is about to happen. Life is not about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. Kiss slowly, forgive quickly. So super cute sentiments. And then over here is Ice Princess PI. And so there's several different varieties of sentiments. And then her, again, super fun to paper piece her up. And then for the dynamics, I got the peace sign. And that's what that looks like. Very cool, like two different sizes. And there's an a la mode stamp that I would actually coordinate nicely with that one. And then I got the icicle border. I didn't get a chance to use this on my card, so I can't wait to use that one. And then this one is the wonky scallop border. So it's a scallop border, but it just goes different size scallops across. Super fun. And then this one here is the crown border, dynamics. As you guys can tell, I am addicted to dynamics. I cannot not buy the dynamics because they are just, it's an awesome product, you guys. I mean, you think about it, getting a die cut machine and getting some dies, it's an investment, but in the long run, you have what you need at your fingertips when you need to create. So that's what I love about the dynamics. And plus, they're very unique and they're very fun to use, not just on cards, but on mini albums, layouts, altered projects, and things of that. So, anyways, happy holidays, everybody, and thanks for watching. Bye.